They will have to get past each other, though. Luca, a past regional champion last year, winning the Liverpool regional championships, and of course making it to top four here in Knoxville, so already equaling that result. And of course, two finalist appearances at international championships in the seniors division in 2019 as well.
Definitely a great list of accomplishments here, and having an opportunity now to be running it down a little bit further than that past top four here at Knoxville last year. Being able to match the placement is definitely great, but you want to make sure you can try and take it that one step further. And this is such a strong team. This Raging Bolt that we've set that we've seen, the Assault Vest combined with things like the Electroweb and the Snarl to be putting the game in your favor, has been definitely one of my favorite ways that this Raging Bolt has been ran.
It's really cool. I think having the ways to like double disrupt your opponent, whether it be in the form of speed or special attack, is really nice, especially considering the Assault Vest on the Raging Bolt combines very well with that Snarl to put a big damper on any kind of special attacker.
And looking over on Toller's end, Senior World Champion, we've got two of those in our top four. And of course, recent results as well, top eight at the past Charlotte Regional Championships just 2 weeks ago, as well as Orlando last year. So of course, you want to try and get that one step further. You already got that top four, why not make it that finalist spot? A little bit of a different Raging Bolt. We do get to see the Snarl, but instead of that Electroweb for the speed control, we get to see something that has a consistency in that Thunderbolt. It's not going to be reliant on your opponent readying up an attack like the Thunderclap is, which definitely changes things up. And notably too, the Golden Go is one of those Pokemon that definitely have to watch out for when piloted by Toller.
This team is all about control. I feel like Toller's main objective with this team is often to set up that Golden Go, get a couple nasty plots up, and make use of something like the Snarl on Raging Bolt, the Tailwind on Tornadus, the Intimidate, Parting Shot, Fake Out, and Incineroar, the Follow Me on the Ogre Pond to enable that Golden Go. And we're gonna see right off the bat, no Golden Go just yet, but Incineroar and Urshifu from Toller facing down the Raging Bolt and Ogre Pond from Luca.
Intimidate over onto the Ogre Pond on Luca's end, of course, with the higher critical hit ratio from that Ivy Cudgel. Maybe might not be relevant in that case, but if you're not getting the crit, it is going to be reducing that damage. The Raging Bolt too, definitely something that can be going on to the offensive on this turn.
Exactly. This Raging Bolt threatens pretty good damage into both of these Pokemon. The Urshifu on Toller's end is the single strike style, so it won't be getting that super effective electric type damage. But not having the greatest special defense, really any kind of special attack into that slot will be enough to threaten it for some good damage and of course break that Focus Sash.
We're going to see that Terra Fairy coming out onto the Raging Bolt. Absolutely fantastic, the little heart on top of the clown.
We can't even see it.
It's amazing, but Fake Out is going to make sure that it can't move this turn. Wicked Blow into the opposing slot, into the Ogre Pond, will bring it down just below half. Ivy Cudgel now, super effective hit into that Incineroar, is going to bring it down a good amount of damage, but no critical hit means the Incineroar is going to live very easily and get that Citrus Berry recovery.
Thanks to that Intimidate Incineroar, it is still at a pretty healthy spot. Has the option to pivot back in and out, reset that Fake Out and Intimidate. And importantly, the Urshifu's Focus Sash was not broken because the Ogre Pond did opt to attack that Incineroar. We saw the Urshifu attack before Ogre Pond as well, which is great for Toller because now if the Ogre Pond takes one more Wicked Blow, it will just be knocked out thanks to the huge damage from that first one. So this Urshifu looking like it's in a pretty strong spot still. The Fairy Terra coming out from the Raging Bolt is a really great defensive option here. You will take almost no damage from anything this Urshifu can throw at you because Fairy is the one type that uniquely resists both fighting and dark, but really can't protect the Urshifu or the Ogre Pond from this Urshifu as a result.
And with that, that Ogre Pond will be going down on the second turn of the battle. And now we get to see that Electroweb. So an opportunity now to be putting the speed in your favor and a decent amount of chip damage onto that Urshifu as well as taking away that Sash. Flare Blitz fired off into the Raging Bolt. We talked about the fact it had the defensive, but it's also just such a great Oki Pokemon. It's gonna take the hit very well.
Yeah, that's a neutral Flare Blitz now. It drops that Dragon typing, which does make it resist Dragon or Fire type moves typically. But that still did well under half HP to that Raging Bolt. So just a testament to how bulky it is. Now Flutterman does come in, and thanks to the Electroweb, the Urshifu's Focus Sash has been broken. That is the booster energy set on the Flutterman, boosting the speed, but we do see it has Dazzling Gleam still. So it's the option to just KO this Urshifu with the Dazzling Gleam, do some decent damage to Incineroar, but the Raging Bolt should easily be able to pick it up here. So a much stronger offensive spot now for Luca.
a sucker punch to make sure that even if you did have that lower speed, you can be doing some damage before things end off. Urshifu taken care of, Incineroar is going to be surviving on a sliver of health here. But of course, with the fact that the Raging Bolt is going to be the faster Pokemon, can fire off Electroweb. It doesn't need to do much. It just needs to get that last couple of HP for Luka to take the double KO on this turn.
And even though Ogerpon got knocked out pretty early on in this game, Luka has now turned it around to have a 4-2 Pokemon advantage. Toler will have to send out his final two Pokemon in the form of Ogerpon and Raging Bolt. Neither of which really love to see this Fluttermane, especially that Raging Bolt being a Dragon-type Pokemon. And of course, Fluttermane on Luka's side does carry Icy Wind. So you have the option to try and get either an Icy Wind or Electroweb off here, possibly set up Luka's final Pokemon for speed advantages throughout the remainder of this game.
What was nice was the Sucker Punch did do a nice amount to the Fluttermane. So even with the Fluttermane being faster, you can be looking at the potential of the Thunderclap, but it's definitely one of those things that it may not quite get KO, so you do have to be careful there at this point. But now, we note, it will be Terrastalization from Toler's end of the field, and that will be the Ogerpon, of course. You want to get that special defense boost, because there is some big special attacking threats over on the opposing end of the field.
There are. The Ogerpon on Toler's side goes for the Terrastalization, will boost its special defense, but Icy Wind coming out from Luka's Fluttermane means that both of these Pokemon on Toler's side will lose one stage of speed.
100%, and at this point, Luka's definitely more than won that speed war at that point, but this Ogerpon still has some speed on its end, and into the Raging Bolt, still just not enough for that KO. Now Dragon Pulse fired off in a return. We really get to see where that body aspect is coming in handy, and Thunderbolt into the Fluttermane, not getting the KO. So good call on the Thunderbolt as opposed to the Thunderclap. Wouldn't have gotten there, but that is a big missed KO.
It's a big missed KO, but they are both now pretty reasonably in Thunderclap range. You have to imagine that Thunderclap from Toler's Raging Bolt is a pretty strong option here. I believe that because of those Icy Winds, the Raging Bolt on Luka's side will comfortably outspeed Toler's. So if you do go for the Thunderclap first, that means your own Raging Bolt can't Thunderclap Luka's Raging Bolt because of that speed interaction. Again, it works just like Sucker Punch, where if you've already attacked or you aren't planning on using an attack move, it just fails. So you have to worry about that, but at least Fluttermane now in a very threatened spot. The Ogerpon on Toler's end, it does have that special defense boost as well that can probably allow it to take one Thunderclap if it needs to.
Going on to here, it is going to be Protect on both ends of the field for one of these Pokemon. So it's just the Raging Bolts that are going to be left to fire off. Thunderclap, that is going to be a fail targeted into a Protect.
Ooh.
And the opposing Raging Bolt with Snarl instead. So that would have been a Thunderclap that failed.
Oh.
But it's a move that doesn't pick up the KO regardless.
Oh my gosh. This Raging Bolt hanging on with one HP means that it sticks around, so the Thunderclap mind game is still there. Toler really can't just freely Thunderclap Luka's Raging Bolt, because if it uses its own Thunderclap, it will fail. Luckily for Toler now, the Thunderclap will be doing a lot less damage because the Snarl does lower the special attack, but you still have the option to get that one Electric-type attack off into Toler's Ogerpon if you need to before it can go for an Ivy Cudgel to knock you out. That is a clutch survival there from Luka Paz's Raging Bolt.
The one HP, the invisible such there at that point. It's crazy to see how low these Pokemon are at that point. And as the timer's going up, gotta be so careful navigating this next turn. It could just be a Thunderclap, and it will be into the Fluttermane. That is gonna be the cleaned up KO, but we will get to see what happens next. It will be the Ogerpon.
Oh, it's still faster.
Still faster and still picking up that KO.
That's a really big outspeed there. The Ogerpon on Toler's side gets to KO this Raging Bolt before it gets the chance to attack, and Luka crucially not going for that Thunderclap. That was the super effective damage into that Ogerpon that Luka had remaining, and possibly trying to, you know, not get baited by something like a Follow Me, by a Spiky Shield. The Thunderclap would have failed if either of those went off, and Luka did not have another Electric-type attack like Thunderbolt that could have dealt consistent damage. We saw him even select the Dragon Pulse there. So a really big turn for Toler now that the Raging Bolt and Ogerpon probably have enough firepower left to take on this Landorus.
Even with the Thunderclap, you could have gotten some damage, but you were at negative one special attack, and you do have the Ogerpon with in-body aspect and special defense boost over onto the opposing end. Earth Power going in to the opposing Raging Bolt is not even enough to be picking up that KO. And now Ivy Cudgel fired off into that Landorus is going to be taking it down for Toler to take the first game of the set.
Well played by Toler. It was really back and forth, right? Toler had a pretty good start to the game, but then Luka took those two KOs with the Fluttermane as it came in, and it looked like Toler might have been on the back foot. That Assault Vest Raging Bolt and the Wellspring Mask Ogre Pond with the special defense boost were able to stand up to the three special attackers Luka had remaining. And even after that, you know, huge Snarl survival on the Raging Bolt on Luka's end, I don't think Luka capitalized enough on that because he just didn't really get much out of the Raging Bolt after that.
It's tough because the Pokemon did survive, but you're also at a point too where the Raging Bolt, it wasn't necessarily threatening maybe as much as you would have liked to, considering the Pokemon that were on Toler's end. So it goes, oh, wow, that survival is really cool, but then kind of what does Raging Bolt do from there, you
right.
know? Because it wasn't like Toler's Pokemon were super, super low to where, like, ooh, I can Thunderclap back and maybe get this KO. It was definitely a little bit of a tricky situation.
I really liked those Wicked Blows early on in that game for Toler. Getting rid of the Ogre Pond on Luka's side was really nice for Toler's own Ogre Pond because it meant it was so much more free to go for those Ivy Cudgels. If the Ogre Pond is still left on Luka's end, you have to worry about going for the Ivy Cudgel into a possible Water Absorb, which means that it's really, really tough to use that move when you might really want to against these very strong Pokemon like Raging Bolt, like Fluttermane. So smart targeting there from Toler. Really good to know for both players that Urshifu does outspeed the Ogre Pond as well. Ogre Pond a bit naturally faster than Urshifu, but often trained to be very bulky. Looks like that is the case for Luka here.
Yeah, Toler with a good amount of speed over on his Ogre Pond as well going on that. So we got to see that Luka did attempt for a little bit more and more speed control, but not able to quite get it in that match and losing quite a bit of momentum there just overall. So I'm intrigued to see where the adjustments are. Obviously, you don't want to be losing your Ogre Pond right and early in that match. You have to have a better answer into the Urshifu over on the opposing end.
You really do. I think that Urshifu, really big deal for Toler there, because even though it was stuck on the field against that Terra Fairy Raging Bolt early on, it did not get baited into going for a Fighting or Dark-type attack into that slot. Now, the Terra Fairy, I think, is specifically for that Raging Bolt while it was on the field, or rather, for the Urshifu while it was on the field, but Toler never even attacked into that slot with the Urshifu at all.
Well, at that point, you have to see what's the bigger threat here, and the Ogre Pond over on Luka's end, definitely super threatening. And we even got to see the fact that Toler's Ogre Pond was allowed to survive and the amount of turns it went through that it was just kind of impossible to be breaking through. So that's definitely going to be a better priority in this next game, is better utilization from that Ogre Pond, potentially Terra. Going into our next game though, that Urshifu that was so impactful in that game one is not going to be here, at least not in the lead. We are going to be having the Raging Bolts on both end of the field. Fluttermane for Luka and Ogre Pond over on Toler's side.
Luka's Raging Bolt like entirely covering up Ogre Pond from our view, saying I'm more important right now. But we do get the kind of mirror match between these two Raging Bolts. Notably, Toler's has Draco Meteor, whereas Luka's only has Dragon Pulse. So if we do get into a scenario where they have to be attacking each other, that might be a benefit for Toler there, because Draco Meteor does a lot of damage right off the bat. But of course, I don't know that you want to be going for that right away when you have a Fairy type and the possibility for Terra Fairy as well.
That's the scary part. Once maybe a Terra is out of the way, it could be a little bit more safer to go for, but you don't want to be hitting a potential of that Draco Meteor into a Pokemon that's completely immune to, because you'll lose so much from there. Terrasilization from Toler's end, though, is not going to be the Raging Bolt, but that Ogre Pond instead, making sure that it has that special defense boost to be facing off against Luka's Pokemon. And then that's going to make sure that Raging Bolt can be taking a lot of damage. Ivy Cudgel next to act, though, targeting into that Raging Bolt. That is very resisted, and it's not going to do much. And actually calling, no Terrasilization coming out and taking the KO onto the Raging Bolt.
That is huge. I really like that. I think when you're facing down an Ogre Pond, Dragon typing is so, so valuable because you're going to be able to resist both the Water and Grass type moves. But calling that correctly, knowing that Raging Bolt probably stays on the field and probably does not Terrasilize, you get a big KO right off the bat with that Ivy Cudgel and Draco Meteor combination. However, you do kind of give up your Terrasilization early on, and Ogre Pond coming in for Luka is in a very good spot here because you have the option to redirect those Ivy Cudgels with your own Follow Me and Water Absorb, and more importantly, you have the super effective Horn Leech now. Considering Toler's Raging Bolt is now at low HP and at -2 special attack, it's not a threat anymore, and so the Ogre Pond on Toler's end is very heavily threatened by Luka's own Ogre Pond.
And that's the thing with the early Terra. So maybe a Terra on Luka's end could have saved that Raging Bolt, but maybe the Terra over on the opposing end not going to be doing quite as much. Moonblast into that Raging Bolt will mean that both players are down that Prehistoric Paradox.
Oh, it went straight for Ivy Cudgel.
It just went straight for it. Toler is not holding back.
Oh.
And into the Fluttermane, critical hit. Another KO for Toler.
That's a really bold play, especially going for Ivy Cudgel in the face of Luka's own Ogre Pond. It makes a lot of sense when you consider that Luka's Ogre Pond is, you know, it's still at full health, right? If it does get redirected, you're not, like, losing any ground that you've made earlier on in the match by getting it HP back. all that happens if you get redirected is nothing, exactly. And so knowing that Luka might need to go for some damage with that slot, that is a big IV cudgel into that Flutter main slot for a clean KO. We saw the critical hit. I really don't think that mattered because a Water Terra Ogre Pond has a lot of physical attack with that IV cudgel, and a Flutter main simply cannot stand up to it.
Toler already taking so much momentum in this match. Sure, your Raging Bolt is gone, but this Ogre Pond has definitely been very, very threatening. And now that Landorus has hit the field over on Luka's end, it's tough because Landorus is going to be a great damage option into that opposing end, but it also is not going to appreciate this Ogre Pond whatsoever. And all of a sudden, if you're forced to be following away, something like that Ivy Cudgel, that's in an Ogre Pond that's not really offering you too much for Luka's end.
At the same time, the Ogre Pond on Toler's end is kind of an issue for this Landorus still. If any Ivy Cudgels come out into that slot, that is some huge damage you really don't want to be taking. And of course, you can also just redirect those Earth Powers and Sludge Bombs with that plus one special defense.
That's going to be a protect over on the opposing end, but that is going to leave this Landorus all out on its lonesome. Another KO.
Not afraid.
No mercy coming out from this Ogre Pond whatsoever.
Oh my.
That's just one Pokemon left for Luka in such a commanding spot for Toler. That's it.
It's the same scenario, right? The Water Absorb taking the Ivy Cudgel really loses nothing if you're Toler, just because you're not really giving it any HP back. And if you get that Ivy Cudgel off into Landorus, that is a game-winning play, and that's exactly what's happening here. Luka going straight for that follow me, kind of conceding defeat. Now all that Toler really has to do is send a couple more attacks, and he'll be moving into the finals here in Knoxville, Tennessee.
Not throwing in the towel, just instead handing it over. Here you go, but wow, what a game two coming out from Toler. The pure aggression coming out. When you're up a game, you can be going for these big moves and these big plays, and Toler really just was not holding back. That was so well played, and he's now on to the grand finals.